second palette. Oh my god, my hair is getting frizzier and frizzier. I don't know if that's good for your eyes. This is just a brand which I've sort of like grown out. It's just a shame that the brand themselves aren't made for all skin tones, but do I see myself buying any of their latest eyeshadows? Probably not. Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Kajal and I'm the face behind High Cruelty Free Beauty. I want to help you become one step closer in being cruelty free in your beauty. And if that's something you're interested in, then please make sure to subscribe. If you don't already follow me on Instagram, then make sure you give me a follow. On there, I like to do product shots and product reviews. Today's video is my top nude eyeshadow palettes. There are two that I would say are not quite as good as the rest of them. And I've decided to show those as well because maybe it'll save you some money from buying them. One of them is quite expensive, so yeah, let's get started. First palette is the I Heart Revolution Galactic palette, and it has a mix of nudes and some brights, but basically I would say it's a nude. It's quite a nice palette. It comes with like a mirror. It has a lot of shades. A lot of them are nude, I would say, but the reason why I wouldn't classify this as a top palette would probably be because some of the shades just don't have a lot of power. Either they don't last or it takes ages to actually pack them on. So I've actually used this shade, which you can see like is like breaking up on my eyes, like here. And what I found was that it just doesn't like pack enough color on. What I'm going to do is I'm going to swatch some of the colors. We'll swatch one of every type that there is. I'm going to swatch one of the matte colors and see how that comes out, so you guys can see how much of a pigment that actually is. As you can see, that was just one swatch, just dipped in once. It's not very good. Now I'm going to do Cosmic Crush. This is like a purple. Okay, that one has a little bit more power, but again, it didn't last all the way through the swatch. So even though I dipped my hand in quite a lot. Then I'm gonna pick one of the shimmery shades. So Black Hole, let's do that one. This is like a duochrome, so it's like black. Oh, it's like a purple actually, it looks like black, but it's like a purpley brown. And I think it looks okay. That one had the highest amount of pigmentation. You can see the one on my eye, which was like a shimmery shade, I think. Then there's also a glitter shade, which I'm gonna swatch, and I think that's all the formulas that there are. I'm not gonna swatch every single color. That's gonna take me ages. Okay, that one is really crumbly, and I don't think the glitter would last on it. I think the glitter is very much just on the top of the shadow rather than actually being on the inside. I don't think this is an amazing palette, but it is a nude-ish palette that I sort of wouldn't recommend. I thought I'd add these in because they'd help you. I think all skins could use this palette because it has got like it's got a good amount of shades. I just think that the quality isn't as good as some of the other ones that I'm going to show you. Let's get on to the next palette. The next one is the Too Faced Chocolate Bar palette. Now, this is quite expensive. Again, it's like a really nice palette because it comes with like a mirror and the shade smell of chocolate. I don't know if that's good for your eyes, because it's actually got cocoa powder in it. I don't know if that's good for the eyes, but it does smell good. I don't mind the smell. It's not overly like sickly or anything. What I have found though is that the quality of the shades aren't very good. So I used this shade for the outer corner of my eye. Now, as you can probably see, and as what I can see, is it's just the color. You can't really see the glitter, which is a bit stupid, because at the end of the day, we've also paid for the glitter as well, and it actually says I mean, it actually shows that it's glittery, but then the color doesn't come off. So yeah, I think the quality of this one, again, is not up to scratch. Although the pigmentation of the matte colors are quite good, let's swatch some of the colors. Let's swatch another shimmery shade that looks like it's supposed to have glitter. Again, it's the same situation. A lot of actual color, but hardly any glitter. The matte shades are very good. I would say they're probably best, but it seems like matte seems like something that every company can do quite well. It's shimmery shades which companies tend to fall on. These foil colors are quite good, like that's actually a good color, but again it's quite broken. But then again, it becomes quite solid once you just rub it a little bit more. So yeah, I think the shimmer shade is quite good. The glitter is not so good. The matte is good as well. But do I think it's worth its price? Probably not. It is friendly for all skin tones, which is good. But it will be number 6 on my list and not any further up, because it's not as good as I would like a palette that I paid so much money for to be. And also, it's a bit tacky at times, like it's not even closing properly. Yes, so I don't think you can charge this much for a palette which can feel a little bit tacky. Let's go on to the next two palettes, because they're from the same brand, so, but they're still 5 and 6. They're from Anastasia Beverly Hills, as you can see. It's the Modern Renaissance and the Soft Glam palette. Both are really great for neutral colors. They've got some really great neutral colors, and they used to be something which I used to take a lot when I traveled, and you can see that because they are quite ruined. The reason why they're so low down is probably because this is just a brand which I've sort of like grown out. I think I've grown out of them because of what they've done recently. I mean, it just was not what you expect from such a big brand. I just feel like they should have taken more of a stance in the whole Black Lives Matter movement. There should have been more talk about it. I feel like it was really like and very much pushed back. And then on top of that, what happened with one of the influencers that was black? Yeah, I don't know. I just feel like as much as I want to rate them as a top brand, I can't do that because they're not very ethical. And I think that's really important. I'm going to swatch some of the shades. I'll swatch a shimmer shade and like a glittery shade and a matte shade, I think. This is a shimmery shade from Modern Renaissance. It's Vermeer. It's quite nice. And I'm gonna swatch a matte shade from Soft Glam. Let's get a Soft Glam matte shade. Very much the same. Oh, yeah. As you can see, it's actually not even amazing quality. The mattes are breaking up. They're quite broken up. Let's try the glittery shade that's in the Soft Glam, which is called Bronze. I know when I got this, I was super excited about the shade, but again, it's something that's really like, has a lot of fallout. It is really like bright and it's really like a nice color. And I probably use these until they get to the pan, but do I see myself buying any of their latest eyeshadows? Probably not. I mean, these are made for all skin tones. It's just a shame that the brand themselves aren't made for all skin tones, because, well, they're not very inclusive. I mean, I can't back them enough to put them at the top. Maybe you should buy these, but I wouldn't buy any of their new drops, especially since they're more related to Norvina, who is the main issue in all of this. Both of these palettes are really expensive. That's why they're like 4 and 5 and not in my top. Because although the pigmentation is good, they last quite well. And I know that because I've used these palettes quite a lot before all of this happened. I was quite a big fan of ABH. They're quite pricey, and also the ethics behind the brand is not great. Oh, behind the other two brands, Too Faced is also not very ethical, so again, but their products aren't good either, so I think they messed up on both ends. Well, this product isn't very good. Okay, let's move on to the next one. Let's go for Morphe next as number three. Now Morphe is a brand that has had issues with their ethics, but they have come back and they have changed their ways. They disassociated themselves with the said person. I'm not going to bring in too much drama, but I think that was a good thing to do, and that made me feel like, yeah, I can back them still and I can still talk about their products, because their products are quite great. I mean, look at this palette for a nude. It is the 35F, which I think is the Frost palette. So let's swatch some of the colours. I'm obviously not going to swatch every single colour, but the pigmentation I know is quite good in Morphe eyeshadows. Their eyeshadows are some of my favourite things. So I'm going to pick like a duochrome colour first. As you can see, just that one swipe and it literally lasted all the way till there. It's just the difference in product. This is why it's definitely in my top three. Now I'm going to pick a bit more of a different type. It's more... it's more like a shimmer shade. It's more like a foil shade. So with a little bit more shine, and I found that one, that's like a really nice purple. So I like that. Then let's do one of their lighter colours. Okay, that's a little bit more broken. It's not as good. Let's finally do one of their matte shades. Okay, so that one, not very good. Yeah, that's a better matte shade. So yeah, I think that their matte shades are good. Their foils are good. Their shimmers are good. And the great thing is that because they have so many shades in one palette, it's accessible for everyone, and all skin colours can use this. They're really affordable, so I would really recommend if you're looking for a nude eyeshadow palette, definitely Morphe is definitely one of the ones that you should go and buy. And let me know what you think if you have bought Morphe palettes, and which one are your favourite. Do you like the nude ones or do you like the coloured ones? Comment down below and let me know. So let's move on to the next palette. So we're on the final two now. My penultimate palette is the new nude palette by Huda Beauty, and I love this palette. It's such good quality. It has so many nice shades, and I feel like I don't use it enough. It actually looks pretty brand new. But it's probably because it's just so pretty. You don't want to use it, but I need to start using this more. I really like the shade. She's actually even put like a concealer type colour in here, which is so amazing because you can use that as a base for your eyeshadow and then use the other colours. I've only realised that today. I've had this palette for ages. Wow, it's clear that I don't use it enough. But I really like the shade range. So there are shimmers, foils, glitters and mattes, and then there's the concealer like shade. I think that's really good. I think the price point of this is a little bit expensive. She does have lots of sales which include this a lot of the times because it's quite an old launch. I would definitely recommend to buy this one. It's just so pretty. But let's try some of the shades. So I'm going to try Crave as one of the foil shades. Okay, so the foil shades are quite bitty, but look at the luminosity. The shine and the glow is real. Then let's try, there's only actually one shimmer shade. It's like a purple. Okay, yeah, really good quality, swiped straight away on, really highly pigmented. Her eyeshadow formulas are really great, to be honest. This one is called Kinky. This is Tickle. It's a little bit ashy, but still quite good. And I'm gonna pick, Infatuated. Let's see what happens. Okay, it actually swatched quite well for a pressed glitter. That's actually really good. Look at that. Yeah, I would definitely recommend this palette. It's why it's number two in my ranking. I definitely think that this is for all skin tones. Obviously the concealer part might not be, but if you use it as a base, then it could be for like deeper skin tones too. But also, she's got these mini nude obsessions, which are made for different skin tones. So as soon as she brought this out, she also brought out the mini nude obsessions. So if you don't like this one, if you think this has got too many, this has got like some pinky tones, but if you want more of like browns, the nude obsessions have a lot of those. I don't have those, but you could get those instead if you want. But I really love this palette, so yeah, let's get on to the top one. Ooh, exciting. The number one palette in my top nude eyeshadows has to be by Juvia's Place, the Nuvian. I really, really love this eyeshadow, and there are so many reasons, because it's so travel friendly. It's like a really nice like size, it's not too big. It just has like the perfect amount of shades, and the quality is unreal. I love Juvia's Place. As you can see, this is very much used. I've even managed to get my friends onto this. They've got some really good shades. I definitely think that it's made for all skin tones. They do think about all skin tones because it's a black owned company, so then they really do make sure that they think about every skin type. I mean, every skin color. It's just the perfect like nude eyeshadow. It's just made for those nude glam looks. Like, you could do like a light glam look, and then you could do like a darker glam look if you want. So yeah, it doesn't have a mirror, but I don't really mind that it doesn't have a mirror, because the quality of the eyeshadow is so good. I don't really care that it doesn't have a mirror. I'm gonna swatch some of the shades. So I'm gonna swatch a shimmery shade that they've got. Like, well, it's like a foil, like a light colored foil. Ooh, that's so nice. That is so pretty, so glowy, so pretty. And then I'm gonna swatch like a shimmer shade. That was like a foil, this is a shimmer. Really nice, like duochrome almost. Came out more pink than I expected, but I really like that. And then let's swatch one of their matte shades. I'm gonna go for like a really, the neutral shade, which I use a lot of, which on my hand looks very white, but on my eyes it looks really good. Yeah, I really like these, and I would definitely recommend this. There are really nice shades like this one. I use this a lot in the inner corner of my eye, or at the top of my brow bone where I need some highlighting. Definitely, if you're looking for a nude eyeshadow palette, especially if you're based in America, you can get this on Beauty Bay, I think, in the UK. But if you're based in America, you can get this so easily directly from their website, which is probably the best way to buy. Oh, I've got eyeshadow all over it. Good thing is, it's actually easily like wipeable too, so if you do get it dirty, you can just wipe it off, so it's okay. And if you do try it, let me know in the comments what you think, or if you have tried it, let me know what you think. I hope you enjoyed today's video. Today is What's Happening Wednesday, so if you have any questions, make sure you leave them down below. At the moment, I don't have any questions to answer. Make sure you drop me a shout out Sunday for this Sunday, so I can pick someone. If you enjoyed today's video, then make sure you subscribe. Also, I might be doing some looks with some of these eyeshadows on my Instagram, so make sure you give me a follow on there. See you next video. Bye.